Gautam Vora stood to present himself in front of the police despite the Mumbai Sessions Court directing him to do so. We keep a track on that aspect, but perhaps Mr. Vora himself is not solely responsible, desperately seeking love and failing every time. That was the sad truth of Viveka's life, one that drove her to a tragic end by her own hand. Viveka was torn by a string of broken affairs. Gautam Vora was only the last in the long list of suitors. After an enduring heartache time and again, the pain perhaps became too much to bear for Viveka.
Young, drop-dead gorgeous, at the top of her career, the life of glitching parties. And then it changed to unhappiness, loneliness, failure in love, financial losses. She sought love, but it proved elusive. It left her emotionally drained. She turned to drugs and drinking. Viveka Babji scorched screens with her Kama Sutra ad with model Inder Mohan Sivan. The relationship turned intimate even when the arc lights were switched off. Inder, though, was already married to fellow model Jesse Randhawa. The affair ended in controversy and left Viveka shattered. Viveka's search for love continued. She began dating writer-director Rohit Jugraj. They got engaged and were expected to tie the knot by the end of 2006. But soon the rumor mills were working. Whispers about Rohit's alleged first wife surfaced, and it was followed by yet another breakup for Viveka.
We were introduced by her cousin who was a friend. We were in a serious relationship for 2 years and broke up in 2007. We were just two different people. It took me a while to get over her.
Alone in Mumbai, Viveka started looking for support. Once again, she was dating. This time, Kartik Jobin Putra, who owned an event management company. But this relationship too did not last for long. They broke up in December 2009 after dating each other for a year.
She was very keen to start an event business, which she had started with Kartik. And it had fallen through and she was disillusioned. Apparently, she indicated that the person had taken the company and she said, no problem, he can have it and I will start anew.
It is a charge Kartik denies.
No, we haven't spoken since Jan.
Okay. Were you guys in a relationship of some kind prior to that?
Yeah, in 2009, yes, we were.
Viveka met Gautam Vora, a stockbroker in Goa earlier this year, and sparks flew. She hoped that this time around the relationship would work out and end in marriage.
Viveka's love life was a string of one broken affair after another. Even her relationship with Gautam Vora was unstable and volatile. She couldn't take it anymore. Perhaps it was the fear of never finding love that pushed Viveka over the edge. And she ended her life. Guys, the case of in Mumbai for headlines.
Alright, that's all we got back for you, at least in this edition of Ground Zero.